here we are going to discuss human male reproductive system. The male reproductive system constitute certain organs. Those reproductive organs can be studied under some headings. Number one, it is primary sex organ, or primary sex gland, or it is gonad, the male gonad, under which we are going to study about a pair of testes. Next, it is the duct system. Under duct system, we are going to study about epididymis, the vas deferens, the ejaculatory duct, and urethra, Then third heading, it is the accessory glands of male reproductive system. There are three glands, namely prostate, then seminal vesicle, then Cowper's gland. Then there are some supporting structures. We are going to study about spermatic cord. Then it is penis and scrotum or scrotal sac. So these are the list of male reproductive organs of humans. So we'll go detail. First we'll move to the primary sex organ or male gonad. There are a pair of testes which are oval in shape. The length varies between 3 to 4 cm and the thickness is about 3 cm and the weight varies between 10 to 40 gram. In case of adult male, this weight is decreased in the old age. And in human cases, the two testes are extra abdominal. That means they are present outside the abdominal cavity or outside the pelvic cavity. The testes are formed during the embryonic life inside the abdominal cavity. But after formation, through a short passage called inguinal canal, let's draw a diagram. Suppose these are two thighs. So, testes is formed inside the pelvic cavity during the embryonic life. And the testes descends through a short passage from the pelvic cavity outside it. And that short passage is called as inguinal canal. This is called as inguinal canal. As it descends outside, so it also brings the nerve supplied to it, the artery and the vein supplied to it along with it. So here there is a band like structure called spermatic cord. Which comprises the artery, vein and nerves supplied to the testes, helps to hold the testes inside the scrotal sac in position. And the two scrotal sacs here, or the two scrotum simply we can say, those are provided with deeply pigmented folded skin, Those super folds are called as rugae. And those two scrotal sacs are asymmetrical. One is present just above to the other. The two testes are held inside the scrotal sac by means of connective tissue. That connective tissue is called as gubernaculum. Gubernaculum. So next we'll move to the coverings and internal structure of the testes. It has three coverings: tunica vaginalis, tunica albuginal, and tunica vasculosa. There are three outer coverings of testes. Here, let's make a covering. This is tunica vaginalis. Next to it, it is, suppose here, let's draw. This is the middle tunica albugina, the connective tissue layer. And next to it, the tunica vasculosa layer. Here, the red line, the red layer here is the tunica vasculosa layer, which is rich in blood vessels, a delicate connective tissue layer. Internally, the testis is divided into many lobules, by fibrous septa. Nearly there are about 200 to 300 lobules inside each testis, and each lobule is supplied with seminiferous tubules, coiled tubules, which are called as seminiferous tubules. Here seminiferous tubules. And those seminiferous tubules, they are interconnected with each other. Here they are connected, here they are connected. And on the posterior part of the testis, they converge to form the recti testis, a network-like structure here, the recti testis. Here another tube comes. And finally, the path leaves the recti testis. This part is called recti testis. Recti means behind. Because this is posteriorly formed, or it is formed behind the testis, that is why it is called as recti testis. The products formed inside the seminiferous tubules, actually and the inside the seminiferous tubule, sperm is synthesized. So sperm moves from seminiferous tubules to recti testis. Then from recti testis, it moves through again a network, straight network, network of straight tubules called as vasa efferentia. Vasa efferentia. Then vasa efferentia, they converge to form a super coiled tube partially encircling the testis. Partially encircling the testis here. This part is called as epididymis. This long folded tube, coiled tube, is called as epididymis. So sperms are synthesized inside the seminiferous tubule. Then from here, they move through the recti testis, and again they move through this vasa efferentia. Then they move through the epididymis, and from epididymis, the latter, another tube arises, which is called as ductus deferens or vas deferens. Then it moves forward. The structures will study it in later. And again we'll move to the internal structure of or histology of each tubule. Let us move to the histology of tubules. Histologically, each testis is divided into two compartments. Histologically, each lobule is divided into two compartments. What are those two compartments? The two compartments are seminiferous tubular compartment, seminiferous tubular compartments, and interstitial compartment. Interstitial compartment. Seminiferous tubular compartment comprises nearly about 80 to 90% of total testicular volume, and the rest 10 to 20% only is formed by interstitial space or interstitial compartment. Let's make a diagram here. Suppose this is the TS of a lobule. In this we'll find seminiferous tubules, seminiferous tubule, and the interstitial space here, interstitial space. First we'll move to seminiferous tubular compartment. Nearly about 2 to 4 seminiferous tubules supplied to each lobule, and each seminiferous tubule is about 50 to 80 centimeter in length. The seminiferous tubule has an outer covering, outer capsule it has, which is called as tunica propria, tunica propria. Next to it lies the basement membrane, and next to it the germinal epithelial layer or germinal epithelium. So seminiferous tubules has three layers: the outer tunica propria, which make a capsule around it, then the middle basement membrane, then the germinal epithelial layer, the germinal epithelium or the germinal epithelial layer. This germinal epithelial layer is made up of two kind of cells. Some cuboidal cells and some pyramidal cells, long pyramidal cells. The cuboidal cells are called as spermatogenic cells, spermatogenic cells. And these pyramidal cells are called as Sertoli cells or sustentacular cells, sustentacular cells, sustentacular cells. So here let us draw those cells. Suppose these are Sertoli cells or nourishing cells, Sertoli cells. Next, the spermatogenic cells. Why these are named as spermatogenic cells? Because these cells synthesize sperm, the male gamete. These cells undergo spermatogenesis process under the influence of testosterone hormone, and from which the sperms are produced. It is the lumen where we can find sperms here, mature sperms. In the wall of the seminiferous tubule only, the spermatogenesis process takes place. So these pyramidal cells are called as Sertoli cells. So this is Sertoli cell, and these are called as, here these are spermatogenic cells, spermatogenic cells. Let's move to the function. The function of spermatogenic cell is that they produce sperms. They undergo certain developmental stages in the spermatogenesis process. We are going to study it in later. So the spermatogenic cell synthesize sperm. That is their function. And the function of Sertoli cell is to provide nourishment to the developing stages of the sperm. And there are some other functions also. Sertoli cells secretes two things. One is inhibin hormone, another is androgen binding protein. The inhibin hormone, when needed, it suppresses the synthesis of testosterone. And ABP, androgen binding protein, concentrates the testosterone here to be utilized by these spermatogenic cells. Then there is interstitial space or interstitial compartment. Interstitial compartments, which constitute nearly about 10 to 20% of total testicular volume, is provided with stroma, the connective tissue, then the blood vessels, lymph vessels, and Leydig cells, a special kind of cells found in cluster here. Draw the cells. Some cells are found in cluster. Those are called as interstitial space, interstitial cells, or Leydig cells. They are discovered by Leydig. As per his name, they are called as Leydig cell. So Leydig cells present in the interstitial compartment, they secrete testosterone. Testosterone, which is otherwise called as the male sex hormone or male androgen, that is produced outside the seminiferous tubule here, but that is utilized by this spermatogenic cell for the synthesis of sperm during spermatogenesis process. The function of androgen binding protein is to bind with the testosterone and help the testosterone to be utilized by this spermatogenic cells. So this is all about the structure of male sex gland. Next we'll move to overall function of testes. Testes has mainly two functions. One is gametogenesis function and other is endocrine function. It has two functions. One is gametogenesis, another is endocrine function. In gametogenesis, it produces the male gamete, sperms, and in endocrine function, that is the formation of male sex hormone, testosterone.